Hi, this is a video on inductive and deductive arguments, and you can get this worksheet on my website at caraleemath.com. Let's look at an example of each one. So here's an inductive argument on the left. I see teenagers skateboarding, my son's friends skateboard. These are specific examples. Therefore, the conclusion, all teenagers like to skateboard. This is going to a general conclusion, all. Think that's true? All teenagers like to skateboard? Let's contrast this with a deductive argument. Deductive, all cars have at least two doors. A Ford Focus is a car. So these are general premises. So we've got all cars have at least two doors. Going to a specific conclusion, a Ford Focus has at least two doors. So let's talk about the properties of the inductive and deductive arguments. We'll talk about whether they're true or false or valid or invalid. The inductive argument first, so that one goes from specific examples to a general conclusion. So let's write that out. Specific examples to a general conclusion. And a deductive argument goes in reverse, from general premises to a specific conclusion. I like to think of it like this. Going from specific to general is kind of broadening out or widening, whereas going from general to specific is starting wide and going narrow. So they go opposite of each other like that. Now, you might be curious what these words mean, inductive and deductive. I was, so I looked them up online and I found the verb induce, which is what inductive comes from. This is Merriam-Webster Dictionary online. So the definition of induce is to move by persuasion or influence. Call forth or bring about by influence or stimulation, like inducing labor. To cause the formation of or produce by induction. So inducing is really like creating something, expanding, persuading. Have to be careful though, because in this example, we are overgeneralizing. Looking at a couple specific examples, then can we conclude that all teenagers like the skateboard? No, we really can't. So that's the danger. That's what we want to avoid doing ourselves and look for in other arguments, is someone overgeneralizing or stereotyping in an inductive argument. Let's look at the verb deduce. So to deduce is to determine by reasoning or deduction. To deduce the age of ancient artifacts is an example. Or she deduced from the fur stuck to his clothes that he owned a cat. This makes me think of Sherlock Holmes, made all these deductions based on his observations. To infer from a general principle. Or to trace the course of. Okay, so deduce is really following the line of reasoning. In this example, all cars have at least two doors. A Ford Focus is a car, therefore a Ford Focus has at least two doors. That is following from a logical premises to a conclusion. So following a line of reasoning or deducing. So let's write induce. And deduce. Kind of makes me think of reduce in a way, because we're starting general and we're going to specific. Okay, so we talked a little bit about this inductive argument, how that's an overgeneralization. We can't say that all teenagers like to skateboard, just from a few examples. So we cannot use an inductive argument to prove its conclusion. Can't do it. We can only evaluate an inductive argument in terms of strength. We can say it's a strong argument or a weak argument or moderate. So we can only evaluate in terms of strength. We can't prove that anything is true on an inductive argument. So at best, if the argument is strong, the conclusion may be true. You really have to evaluate it for yourself, whether you think it's true or not. Now, the difference is with a deductive argument, we can use a deductive argument to prove its conclusion. This is saying all cars have two doors. If Ford Focus is a car, therefore, if Ford Focus has at least two doors, that follows. So we can use a deductive argument to prove its conclusion. And we evaluate a deductive argument with two different things. Not all deductive arguments are true. This one is. So we evaluate it in terms of its validity and soundness. Is the argument valid and is it sound? Okay, so valid, the valid part means that the conclusion follows from its premises. So in this case, a Ford Focus having at least two doors follows from the fact that all cars have at least two doors and a Ford Focus is a car. So this is a valid argument. The conclusion follows from the premises. However, someone might be making an argument with false premises, so that's the issue. You might have false premise, and then something that follows from those premises. And it's not, it's a valid argument, but it's not a sound argument. So for soundness, what we're looking at is, are the premises true? So let's evaluate these. All cars have at least two doors. Is that true? I think so. I can't think of a car that doesn't have at least two doors. So that's true. A Ford Focus is a car. That's true. So if the premises are true and the conclusion follows from the premises, it is a sound argument or a true argument. Let's move this up a little bit. So the premises are true in order to be sound. And the argument is valid. So if the argument isn't valid, we can really stop there. If it's not valid, it can't be sound. But if it is valid, if the conclusion follows, then we need to check, are the premises true? And then it is a sound argument. Okay, so here's some for you to try. First, we're going to just determine whether each argument is inductive or deductive. So we have three examples here. I'd like you to pause the video and decide whether each one of these is inductive or deductive, and then restart the video and we'll talk about it. Okay, so let's go through each one. If Dennis misses work and there's a party at work, then Dennis will miss the party. So we wanna think, is this going from general to specific or specific to general? If Dennis misses work, that's a general. And there's a party at work. Then, very specifically, Dennis will miss the party. So this is deductive. also, you can see, you can conclude that this is true. Dennis will miss the party. So that's another way that I use. Could we prove this conclusion? Have we proven this conclusion? Okay, let's look at the second one. The chair in the living room is red. The chairs in the dining room and bedroom are red. Therefore, all chairs in the house are red. Okay, chair in the living room is red. That's a specific example. Chairs in the dining room and bedroom are red. Therefore, all, so this is general. And we're starting specific. So specific to general, this is an inductive argument. We can't prove, there's no way we can know if all the chairs in the house are red unless we've seen all the chairs, but then we're at a deductive argument. So just because we've seen some examples, we could say this is a strong argument because we've got a lot of chairs in the house that are red, but we still cannot prove that all chairs in the house are red. So that's an inductive argument. And the last one, it's dangerous to drive on icy streets. The streets are icy, so it's dangerous to drive now. It's dangerous to drive on icy streets. So dangerous, that seems general. General, it's dangerous to drive on icy streets. The streets are icy, so it's dangerous to drive now. This is following from these two premises, so this is a deductive. Okay, so again, this leads to this, which leads to this. It's dangerous to drive now. This follows from these two premises. However, it may be true or not true. Right? Is it really dangerous to drive on icy streets? You might have an opinion about that. Yes, it is. Or no, not really. So it could be sound or not sound. This could be more of an opinion thing. I personally think it's dangerous to drive on icy streets. And so if the streets are icy, then I would say it's dangerous to drive. All right. Thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you on the next one.